Hello guys, the experiment which we are going to do is conversion of galvanometer into voltmeter. The conversion of galvanometer into voltmeter, the derivation part, the formula part, we have already studied in the theory. Today we are going to do the practical for that. So let's go for the practical. This is a basic experiment details. To convert the given galvanometer of known resistance and figure of merit into a voltmeter of desired range and verify the same. The range we have decided for the voltmeter is 0 to 3 volt. This range will definitely be given to you in examinations. This is a basic circuit diagram. First of all, we have connected a battery with a rheostat. Then positive of the battery is connected to the voltmeter and galvanometer. Galvanometer is connected in series with the resistance, and then this junction, common junction, is connected to the third terminal of the rheostat. Okay, so this is what we are going to do. Resistance of galvanometer will be given to us here. The given value is 450 ohms. Figure of merit is definitely given to us, 20 microampere per division. That is 20 microampere per division. The galvanometer current, total galvanometer current, if you see that there are 30 observations, 30 divisions, there are 30 divisions in the galvanometer. You can see 30 divisions here. Okay, so one division is of 20 microampere, so overall 600 microampere. Okay, one division is for 20 microampere, 30 divisions multiplied by total current becomes 600 microampere. Range of the voltmeter is 3 volt. These are the values given to us. The resistance which we have to connect in series with the galvanometer, if we calculate the value, V is 3 volt. We put up the values. V is 3 volt. Galvanometer current is 600 into 10 to power minus 6, 600 microampere. Galvanometer resistance is 450. If you put up the value, this will sum up to 5000 minus 450. That comes to be 50, 4350. If I am not wrong, yes, 4350. The value is 4350. Is it 43? Let us see that. No, it will be 4550. 4550. Yes. 4550. 4550 ohms. Okay. So this is the value which we have to basically take out. Now the least count of the galvanometer which we are converting, means galvanometer which we are converting into voltmeter, for that definitely number of division is 30 volt. So 3 volt is a range which we have to basically convert. So least count becomes 0.1 volt per division. That least count will be used here in this table. Observations, we have to take 4 to 5 observations to verify the same. Okay, so let's go to the circuit diagram now to assemble the circuit. To assemble the circuit, one by one we'll do it. First of all, just see here, galvanometer is connected to a resistance and in parallel with the voltmeter. So let us do this part. First of all, galvanometer is connected in series with the resistor. So galvanometer is being connected in series with the resistance box. Now this combination is connected in parallel with the voltmeter. So this terminal red will be connected with this terminal voltmeter, and this terminal will be connected with this of the voltmeter. This much part of the circuit is done. Now the common terminal of voltmeter and galvanometer is connected to this terminal, but before that battery should be connected to a rheostat. So we connect positive terminal and negative terminal with the rheostat. We can fix the battery to 4 volt. It is at 0 volt, 2 and 4. Negative terminal. To one part, now positive terminal to the other part, this positive terminal is connected to this terminal of rheostat. You can see that we have used two base terminals. These are two base terminals. The top terminal, which is connected to the slider, is still to be connected. Now just see here in the circuit, battery is connected to rheostat. The slider terminal will be connected to the common connection of resistor, resistance box and the voltmeter. This is the common terminal. This will be connected to the this part, and galvanometer common terminal will be connected with the this part. So let us complete the circuit now. The positive of the galvanometer, or the positive of voltmeter you can say, is connected to the terminal where positive of the battery is connected. This is the terminal where positive of the battery is connected. Okay. And this terminal is connected to the upper sliding portion of the rheostat. Here the circuit is complete. The circuit is definitely looking like a little bit messy, but the circuit is correct. If you go a stepwise manner, then the whole circuit is correct. Now we have to verify the things. Before verification, we remember that we have the value of resistance 4550 ohms. So again, from the resistance box, we will take out the resistances, that is 4000. So you can see that here the resistance box, 2000 plus 2000 is 4000, 500, and this is 50. So the resistance is connected to the galvanometer now. The resistance is connected to the galvanometer now. What we have to do? We have to now verify. The verification part is pending. In verification part, we have a table got deflection, the number of divisions of galvanometer, which is converted into voltmeter, then the voltmeter, and we verify it with the value of voltmeter. So let us see here. Switch on. At zero, galvanometer is also zero. The initial part is verified. Now we'll set up it to 1 volt. We can see here the number of divisions coming is 10. So we write the number of divisions of galvanometer, that is 10. 10 into the least count of galvanometer was 0.1. That comes to be 1 volt. And the standard voltmeter gives me 1 volt. So the error between these two values is zero, no error. We again set the value to the 2 volt now. We can see that the number of divisions coming here is 20. So for 20 divisions, to convert into volt, that is 2 volt. Here it is also 2 volt. Error is 0, no error. We take it to 3 volt now. So here you can see that it is bypassing 30. We approximately take is 30. 30 divisions, that is multiplied by least count, equal to my 3 volt. Standard voltmeter is also 3 volt. Error is almost 0. So the circuit is verified that the galvanometer we have converted is correct. We can see here 10 divisions, 20 divisions, 30 divisions. For 10 divisions, galvanometer showed 1 volt. Voltmeter also showed 1 volt. No error. 20 divisions, the galvanometer showed 2 volt. Stand voltmeter also showed 2 volt. The error is 0. For 30 divisions, the galvanometer showed 3 volt. Stand voltmeter shows 3 volt. The error is 0. So the result, we will write that as a difference in actual and converted readings. This is actual and this is converted. Is very small or negligible or 0. The conversion is perfect. We can perfectly convert the voltmeter, the galvanometer into voltmeter. See, this voltmeter is also made in the same way. Generally, in ammeter, voltmeter and galvanometer, we have the same setup. We have the same assembling of all the parts. But if we increase the resistance of the galvanometer by connecting in series, then it will behave as voltmeter. And the same is done here. Okay. So that is all for this experiment. Thank you.